came here before OKR Cali, Native Magistrate Court in Russell, where that British title was stamped into history here, has been overlooked, and the New South Wales took over from there as the secretary on the 1835 Declaration of Independence and leading to the 1840 treaty signed here. So the authority, as far as I'm concerned, as a native land commissioner, is to verify that this is the piece of land that the Treaty of Waitangi was signed by the 75 or so chiefs to authenticate these documents back to them and back to Hori Te Huri on the top of the hill as a paramount chief with the same likeness of documents as Rewherewha Manukau of Awhitu in the south of Manukau Harbour. That's Manukau Marae. It was changed to Tahuna Marae by the Minion Karen. I've got all that history on record and on video in the time of Tamaki Manukau. In the 6 years I spent with him identifying his area of his paramount chief, Rewherewha Manukau, and Te Rau Waikato Whare Manukau. Te Rau Waikato came from Cambridge, or Mangatauturi Mountain, as being the first contact to Cambridge University in Britain, where he and Hongiheka went to learn English, and Hongiheka was responsible for the security of the investment interests of this land and its titles to commerce, trade, in the sea, around the whole world, with our native title locked in the contract so that it would not be pirated. This is a pirate flag to keep pirates out. And so we are still in the contract today, and we are just reasserting our sovereign powers and our authority of the king. I'm acting as surrogate king, William the Fourth, for this flag, speak for the king, and until there's a king put into Westminster. Now, I'm saying this for the record that King Ernest Augustus, the fifth, is the reigning monarch of Britain, UK, Hanover, and Aotearoa, New Zealand, Pacific Islands. As far as we're concerned, we have done that in Te Kī Marae and Waitangi Marae. Put him as our oath of office, though he's not there. He has been the only king that's incumbent of the king to king title. In sailor law forbids women from succeeding. But the Queen has her own title. She has gone to EU Parliament and is abandoned ship and left her Maori people afloat to sort themselves out. So this is the way to sort the Maori side of the 1835 flag, of the other half of this flag, and the 1840 treaty, which we can now report to Britain from here with the blessings of this church and our minister, Manahini, to officiate and authenticate these documents before I go to Westminster with Morris or Robo, as his name is called, Morris Baker or Pekka, and his wife, Mary Ann. To assist myself and Manahi to take this discovery of old back to identify ourselves in the flag. And they will recognise their British settlement here as authentic to all native countries in the world. And we're just putting the record straight for Ngāpuhi, because they will get help from Britain. But it's turned the other way into the Queen and the Rothschild banks took it and it went that way. So we are putting it back into the King's Bench Court, which we operate now at the moment. Inside Tahiti Marae is now a Native Magistrate Court, Britain Direct. So with that, I just want to say from our Rangitukia area, one more final point is that the St. Mary's Church is 1831, where the birth, death, and marriages of the the British fathers were put together as a blueprint for all the universities and marriage certificates in the world through King William IV in New York on the Stock Exchange. So I'll just briefly say that that's where it came from on my land rocks and the Rahuni Morai, Tiki Tiki, and the Rangitukia Native Magistrate Court was a schoolhouse there where these documents were signed with Clendon, James Reddy Clendon, captain of his Admiralty ship, British ship, when signed here at Okeaka Native Magistrate Court in the Auckland provincial area of described from north Terere Wairu or Cape Reina down to south of Taupo in a line east to west. All of that area was the province of Auckland at this time these contracts were made. So that's the part of the birth certificates and the fashioning of titles and instruments over the land. The land is still there, but I'm talking about documents that created the wealth that they enjoy and that we have not yet. But we are still two-party contract with the British direct, and everything else is third party. I'm saying here, for the record, that the mana lies here on this piece of land. Titi Marae and Waitangi Marae is a third party with a New South Wales and New Zealand government crown, and we are the crown of Britain today and on the record, for the record. And so I'm saying the 8-point star on the flag of St. Patrick comes from Belfast in Northern Ireland, Protestant Church. My Rogan's family comes from there as judges here in Aotearoa Native Court in Helensville and Mohi Tamaki Manukau, where I started research with his whakapapa and then ended up on my own at home. The escape, those instruments and the St. Patrick's Church in Belfast, Downpatrick Village County, is what formed the birth, death, marriage certificates and all the other certificates to collect the royal revenue for these kings from the councils and fashioned as rates and administrative costs and everything of prized possessions comes under this 8-point star. You'll see John Key wearing it here just recently, and I'm wearing it on my hat, and anybody else that's a sheriff in these courts have the authority. It's for you people watching around the world to decide which is authentic. And I'm saying we're going back to Britain to take our authentic findings today. After today, we have a meeting in the Wakamurai in Auckland Epsom, where the Manukau title is put inside that Marae to this Marae here, enjoying Ngāpui with the Moriori and the Tahiti, and our one. That's the way to bring all the people together, is to identify who we are and where we come from. And that includes Pākehā and everybody. Once and for all, we'll put the history in its right place where it should be, and it should turn out, as far as I'm concerned, it should turn out exactly right. So, with that, I'm saying that with those St. Mary's Church, St. Patrick's Church, and our King, with the flag he gave us to protect that business, and it goes on, it's not cut, we have to go to Britain to either extend it or replace the trustees, the Queen, and Andrew, and the King and Queen of Spain. The King has died of Spain, has left the Queen of Spain, and their son, Felipe, King Felipe, took over from his father, but not the trust. The trust belongs to us, the Queen Victoria Trust, 1848, still belongs to us. So we have to identify ourselves with any sort of claim to that. So I'm just saying the book here is a magistrate court portable to be on any Marae in the world or any Marae in New Zealand, Pacific Island, and in any court in the world takes precedence because it's a king's court and the king has put all these laws in fashion and design, all the acts of commerce and of everything that has built this country to where it is, with all its buildings, infrastructure, roads, and everything, has come out of this law. We have instructions here, the acts of King William IV, 1830 to 1837, to match up ahead. And that's all we had to do all these years. We now go to enforce those laws into law here and through the world where the plan wins. So that's all I want to say today. And I'll leave the rest of the final word to Apokolo, so the rabbi of the church, and he has all the hallmarks of T.W. Ratana in this area where all this was going on at the same time as the arrival of the Methodist Church, where the Ratana Church originated, and at this time of Holi, and through that time of Ramika, his father, is buried down below on the hill, on the flat behind, where Morris and I sat with Marianne inside the church. He has occupied the church and the land, and he has recovered all the land back that he had got, at least 10 of them, and my job is to put them back further, remove the alien title and put it back into the deed title, where it came from in the first place to Britain, and no more mortgages, no more debts, and remove it from the property as a land commissioner. Land commissioner, that's my job on the Rogan trap side, on the Rogan document side, and on the Cosgroves lawyer side. The Cosgroves married my wife, was at the East Coast, and so that's, you'll see me talking somewhat like a judge and somewhat like a lawyer. In fact, that's what I do. There my son is running me, and the brother Crown part is Tahiti Roy from Easter Island, Kipito, the birth of the world on Easter Island in Kipito, at the East Gate on our Maunga Rocks, where this magistrate court was. That is why the Roman married the Maunga and married the Manukau, for that reason of these documents of two families to make it get this far. So, with that manahi, I just wanted to acknowledge that Rāmeka was living and practicing the church with the Wesleyan church in Whirinaki with the Russell family. My good friend Laura Hoffman, German, Russell, English, is living here at that time in Raleigh and in that very year. And the Russell is the Navy family, one of the Navy families, went to Russell. That's her name in Russell. And she'll verify her side of these authentic documents at any stage to put the record right of her arrival, of her British people. And so that's all I want to say today. It's all yours from now, Manahi. Thank you for the opportunity to witness with you today.
Thank you. però con lui ho detto che te lo ritorno. Ho detto che mi ha amato, ho detto che tu vado a noi. Poi che ricevete le mie mani e la vacca tua, in cui hanno letto mano e tutto con me. Ai miei lacrimi, ah. I've got a few documents to sign from that. And there's any questions wanting to ask over. I just for political data.
There's only three or four documents.